Egyptians ascribed to Thoth the invention of writing. Thus, he became the writer of the Aeneid, who records the holy words. He was responsible for numbers and calculations, being the lord of time and age, and the estimator of years. He recorded and calculated the years gone, and granted longer years to kings. Jehoti was the god of all places of knowledge, and all the writings of the letters were under his supervision, being the lord of the house of life. It's not surprising that Thoth knew the secrets and the magic works that are unknown even to other gods. He played an important role in the netherworld. So we see him in the scene accompanying chapter 125 of the Book of the Dead, standing in front of the balance, in which the heart of the deceased is measured to record the result needed to determine the fate of the deceased. That role had casted on Thoth the reputation of justice and straightness. The importance of Jehoti remained as a god of the moon, and it has formed an important side of his character, and he was placed in a cosmic coordinates with the sun god, as an embodiment of the night sun. In later period, he acquired the adjective of out on the silver. There are tens of statues and figures of god Thoth in the shape of the ibis bird or the monkey that belong to different historical periods. Thousands of mummies of the ibis or the sacred monkey were found in Tunnel Jebel Cemetery. The name of Thoth appeared in the names of several New Kingdom kings who bore the name of Jehoti Mes or Thutmosis, meaning the son of Jehoti, or Jehoti was born. This clarifies the royal importance which his cult acquired.